Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise and remain standing for the arrival of the official party, honors for the Chief of Naval Operations, parading of the colors, the national anthem, and invocation. Parade the colors. Ladies and gentlemen, the national anthem will be sung by musician second class Nina Church from the Navy Band Northeast. Please join her in singing the national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we'd hailed at the twilight gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we'd watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Retire the colors. Chaplain Douglas Rosander, Naval War College Chaplain, will now deliver the invocation.
Let us pray. From the book of Proverbs, an intelligent heart acquires knowledge, and the ear of the wise seeks knowledge. Sovereign Lord in heaven, we ask for your presence with us today. Graduation marks a milestone in the life of each one being recognized for their months of hard work and perseverance. These students have been stretched and challenged and have passed the test. As a result of their time here, May they be better equipped to lead, serving their nations and benefiting others. Thank you for their instructors and mentors, as well as their families and friends who have encouraged them along the way. Now, Lord, please be with those being recognized today for their achievements, and keep us all mindful of your presence. Through the blessed mediator, amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Captain Mark Turner, Director of the Naval Staff College, and Professor Walt Wildeman, Deputy Director of the College of Distance Education, will characterize the graduating classes.
In today's ceremony, there are 75 nations represented in the graduating class. They are Republic of Albania, People's Democratic Republic of Algeria, Republic of Angola, Argentine Republic, Commonwealth of Australia, Republic of Azerbaijan, Commonwealth of the Bahamas, People's Republic of Bangladesh, Federative Republic of Brazil, Republic of Bulgaria, Republic of Cameroon, Canada, Republic of Chile, Republic of Colombia, Republic of Croatia, Dominican Republic, Republic of Ecuador, Arab Republic of Egypt, Republic of El Salvador, Republic of Estonia, French Republic, Georgia, Federal Republic of Germany, Republic of Ghana, Hellenic Republic, Republic of Guatemala, Republic of India, Republic of Indonesia, Republic of Iraq, State of Israel, Japan, Hashemite Kingdom of Jordan, Republic of Kazakhstan, Republic of Korea, State of Kuwait, Republic of Latvia, Lebanese Republic, Libya, Republic of Lithuania, Malaysia, Islamic Republic of Mauritania, United Mexican States, Montenegro, Kingdom of Morocco, Republic of Mozambique, Kingdom of the Netherlands, Federal Republic of Nigeria, Kingdom of Norway, Sultanate of Oman, Islamic Republic of Pakistan, Independent State of Papua New Guinea, Republic of Peru, Republic of the Philippines, State of Qatar, Romania, Independent State of Samoa, Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, Republic of Senegal, Republic of Singapore, Republic of South Africa, Democratic Socialist Republic of Sri Lanka, Kingdom of Sweden, Taiwan, United Republic of Tanzania, Kingdom of Thailand, Republic of Trinidad and Tobago, Tunisian Republic, Republic of Turkey, Ukraine, United Arab Emirates, United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland, United States of America, Oriental Republic of Uruguay, Socialist Republic of Vietnam, and the Republic of Yemen.
The following armed services of the United States and government agencies are also represented in the graduating class: United States Navy, United States Army, United States Marine Corps, United States Air Force, United States Coast Guard, United States National Guard, the Department of the Navy, Department of the Army, Department of Defense, Department of State, Department of Justice, Department of Homeland Security, Department of Commerce, Department of Energy, Department of Veteran Affairs, the White House, the United States House of Representatives, the United States Senate, the Office of the Director of National Intelligence, Federal Bureau of Investigation, Central Intelligence Agency, Defense Intelligence Agency, United States Customs and Border Protection, United States Special Operations Command, National Security Agency, National Geospatial Intelligence Agency, Naval Criminal Investigative Service, the United States Maritime Administration, the Military Sealift Command, Defense Travel Management Office, United States Marine Corps Intelligence Agency, Government Accountability Office, Naval Surface Warfare Center, Naval Air Technical Data Engineering Service Command, United States Pacific Fleet Command, Naval Oceanographic Service, United States Secret Service, Drug Enforcement Agency, Naval Air Systems Command, National Park Service, Naval Sea Systems Command, Naval Mine and Anti-Submarine Warfare Command, Office of Naval Intelligence, the Government Printing Office, the Space and Naval Warfare Systems Command, and the Defense Threat Reduction Agency.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to present Rear Admiral John N. Christenson, the 53rd President of the United States Naval War College.
Summer began 9 hours ago. The weather remains perfect. It's Friday. Our one and only Chief of Naval Operations is here, and it's graduation day. Life is good. Good morning and welcome to our graduation ceremony for the Naval War College class of 2013. Shakespeare wrote, "All things are ready if our minds be so." And today, Spruance Auditorium is full of leadership with minds that are ready. I would like to introduce the distinguished individuals who are here on the stage with me. Please hold your applause until they are all standing. Dr. Jay Hickey, College of Distance Education. Captain Alan Abramson, Chairman of the Joint Military Operations Department. Dr. David Cooper, Chairman of the National Security Affairs Department. Dr. John Maurer, Chairman of the Strategy and Policy Department. Professor Thomas Mangold, Dean of International Programs. Admiral Jamie Kelly, Dean of College of Operational and Strategic Leadership. Dr. John Garofano, Dean of Academic Affairs. Ambassador Marianne Peters, Provost. And our guest of honor, Admiral Jonathan Greenert, who I will formally introduce in just a few moments. Please help me recognize them. Today we are honored to be joined by many distinguished guests, including former elected officials, ambassadors, and active duty and retired admirals and generals, as well as attachés from our partner nations around the world. I want to thank and congratulate General Steve Sider, the new chairman of the Board of Trustees, and all of the members of the Naval War College Foundation. Their generous efforts always make a difference here in Newport. Navy Band Northeast, as always, well done. Mrs. Greenert, thank you for being here, and thank you for all of your service for others. My family, Teresa, Grace, Tim, and Matt, I love you. Thank you all for joining us. We are extremely proud of our student body. We are inordinately proud of our faculty and staff. To all of our civilian team, despite the perfect storm of a hiring freeze, dramatic reductions in your lifeblood of travel and meeting with your colleagues both here and around the world, and now the mandatory furlough, that you remain so totally committed to our mission to educate leaders makes you worthy of our greatest respect and admiration. To the families and friends of our graduates, thank you. Your love and support is the underpinning of the success we are celebrating today. And finally, to our students, I promised you that if you read every word, you would become changed forever. We are confident that you are. I reminded you that to whom much is given, much is expected. From you, we now expect the best. We believe Edmund Burke's famous insight that all that is necessary for evil to succeed is for good men to do nothing. Well, this morning, Spruance Auditorium is filled with good men and women who will lead lives of action. We have taught you how to think, not what to think, while underscoring the importance of your personal integrity, your leadership, and your ethics. You have read, studied, thought, and written. You are ready now to begin the rest of your careers and the rest of your lives, ready to think and ready to lead. It is now my honor to introduce our guest speaker, to welcome the Chief of Naval Operations back to Newport and back to the Naval War College. A native of Butler, Pennsylvania, 35 miles north of Pittsburgh, and last year Smithsonian Magazine named Butler one of the 10 best small towns in America. Admiral Greenert graduated from the U.S. Naval Academy in 1975 and completed studies in nuclear power for service as a submarine officer. His career as a submariner included assignments aboard the fast attack submarines USS Flying Fish, USS Tautog, the research submarine NR-1, the fleet ballistic missile submarine USS Michigan Gold Crew, and command of the fast attack submarine USS Honolulu. His other major fleet command assignments included Commander Submarine Squadron 11, Commander U.S. Naval Forces Marianas, Commander U.S. 7th Fleet, and Commander U.S. Fleet Forces Command. Prior to becoming CNO, he served as the 36th Vice Chief of Naval Operations. In 1992, he was awarded the Vice Admiral Stockdale Award for Inspirational Leadership. He assumed duty as the 30th Chief of Naval Operations on 23 September 2011. 23 September was the same day Matthew was born, and the same day John Paul Jones said, "I have not yet begun to fight." Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming the 30th Chief of Naval Operations, Admiral Jonathan Greenert.
Well, we can lead a Navy, but opening a bottle of water sometimes gets complicated. You were talking in my cap. Never mind. You know, you folks know how lucky you are having John Christenson and Terry up here. I'm not sure you do, but you ought to understand how lucky you are, because you can't match this man and this woman for a leadership team, and of course their family. John, please pass my admiration and my thank you to your faculty. I met, as you know, a few of them here for educating the next generation of leaders. This is like just such a shot of adrenaline to be here. The last 24 hours, we went to Ottawa to attend the change of office for the chief of the Royal Canadian Navy, and to be there and see a peer move on and somebody to come in right behind him who is so skilled, and somebody that I know, that Darlene and I know, was amazing. So we came here last night. It was beautiful, as you know. We went down and had something to eat out here on the terrace, and we ran into so many kids going to OCS. And so they are so excited. Many of them were prior enlisted, and they just couldn't believe how excited they were to either graduate, or it's only three more weeks, and then to be here this morning and speak to what I see is the leadership, the next generation of folks around the world, to have a brief conversation, and I will be brief on that, and to hand you your diplomas. It's truly an honor. I want to welcome back the Navy Command Course class of 93, represented by right away a very, very close friend of mine, Guillermo Barrera and Anna Marie. Thank you very much for being here. You are a hero. You are. Admiral Mena, Admiral Jensen, and Admiral Santos are here representing their Philippines, Denmark, and Cote d'Ivoire as well. Congratulations to the award winners and distinguished graduates today, who we will recognize. And you also have a very unique individual, Carl Gerhardt, who leads your band up here. He's one of the best, so congratulations to that, and thank you to the band again. Family, friends, joint service members, international partners, I see my friends here in the attaché corps. To you, I say thank you for what you do, and your spouses are here. You represent your country here in a very difficult time, and it's not lost on me as I go around Washington the things that you have to carry on behalf of your nation, and then as I travel to meet my counterparts, what you do for them, I thank you very much for that. You are partners in this, shipmates in my regard, and thanks so much for being here today. It's important to all of us. So, a year here at the Naval War College means to recharge a little bit, they say, but hopefully to expand yourself intellectually. And the president here spoke about that, and I believe in it. I believe in it deep in my heart that this is the best institution to come to. And if you don't want to believe me and say, well, of course you believe this. You wear the white uniform and say, how many times has Marty Dempsey been up here? You know, and they had Carlisle saying, hey, what's with this? You know, and it ain't because of lobster. All right? He recognizes a good thing when he sees it. You have a great institution here. So your bags are packed and you're ready for the next adventure. Some of you have already gone. Some of you are here, but you've already gone. And I understand that. There are just a few words I want to relate to you. You've studied history, you learned new skills, and you've made friends. And if I leave you one thing, and I know Admiral Barrera would vouch for me, absolutely, the friends piece. Don't forget who you've met here, especially the international folks. The individuals that you've met, you're here because your nation, your service, believes in you and believes that you have potential and you will be a leader. And the people that you see around you are the same. So who are you going to call, write, text, tweet when things get tough and you're leading? It's going to be the people around you. So these friends, never underestimate the friends you make and these international fora that you have here today. Before you depart today, I just want to share two quick things with you. I want to talk just a little bit about leadership and about commitment to the institution. You represent current and future leaders. I've said that. 5 services, 17 agencies, 75 nations. And that's astounding when you think about that, what this institution brings. Each of you have a unique culture and a unique insight in what's needed in this world today, and none can be undermined by the other. They're all very important. And despite the differences, one thing I can tell you, as you return home and you go back to whatever it is you're doing, whether it's here in other federal agencies, here in the Navy or otherwise, or your nation, your organization needs you. It needs you to be innovative. It's going to need you to be bold in thought, confident in that you can do the job, because you can. And also, you have to be accountable for your actions and for your institution that you represent. And you need to commit to that institution. If you wear this uniform that I wear, if you wear actually any U.S. military uniform, you know you raised your right hand several times, and you said you will support and defend the Constitution of the United States against all enemies, foreign and domestic, and you would bear true faith and allegiance to that Constitution and to this country, not to your shipmate, your wingman, your partner, your buddy, or anybody else, to that institution. And I guarantee you, you will be challenged in this regard. It may seem minor, it could be major, but you will be challenged in this. And you need to think about where you're going to come down on that when that time comes. I ask you to think about that. And remember what you raised your hand, your right hand, and said you would do. You need to be judicious. When I grew up, and I'm still growing up, but as I went through time and I went to Capstone, which was sort of the first thing you go to when you're a flag officer, people said, you know, I don't want to be one of them there budget people, green eyes shape people. I'm an operator. I'm not a provider. I said, oh, really? As life goes on and we move through the ranks, we are all responsible for the resources that our nation gives us, because it's people. It's the people's time. It's fuel. It's ships, airplanes, and everything else. And we just don't give and say, hey, use them up. And it never happened that way throughout history. And those of you who studied history, and you have, hopefully this is sinking in, that this is a combination of those two. You got to have skill. Some said amateurs study tactics. I don't know that. And professionals know logistics. And there's truth, perhaps, in both ends of that. So we're in Spruance Hall, a great place to talk about leadership and a great individual to represent those factors of leadership I laid out to you. Innovation, to start with. That guy was an innovative leader. He was here from 26 to 27. During the time, as we do today, they did wargaming. And they talked about this thing called carriers and what they might be and what we might make them be as we look ahead in the interwar period and say, what value might they have? He had 2 subsequent tours, and he saw more of this war gaming. He was on the ground floor for the innovation of using carriers at sea for strike. And he formed thoughts, and he said, you know, The battleship is the king, perhaps, but it's not necessarily what we need for every instance out there. And he gave this some great thought. Today there are articles written about aircraft carriers, and heaven help us, that maybe there's something to follow, and we need to think about that. And that's good debate. That kind of debate has been out there for a while. Spruance said, he put in his mind, you know, it's the capability I need, not just the platform. Everything is not the platform-based. What do you bring in the capability? And that was in his mind. He was calculated, and he understood something that's pretty darn hard to do. How do you take risk? We use the term risk a lot. When we use it in Washington, that means less. We're going to take risk in your account. You get less money. That's what it means. And you say, well, what does that mean? What do I do with that? And say, well, how about we do a little bit of where will we be when we do that? And if you can't talk about that and you don't understand it, it's part of judiciousness, you probably will get more risk. And that's the way the world works in that particular meaning or being. So this is Spruance, an innovative guy who understood new ideas and think about capability, what would it bring. Now, after the war, as time went on, an instructor here was attributed, here at the War College, was attributed to say to his course, during your course here, your course of instruction, you'll be given atomic bombs, guided missiles, and super performance torpedoes to work your problems. In their use, you will be unhampered by doctrine because, well, there isn't any. And people hate that. I mean, my folks say, hey, we need more doctrine. We need, and I say, dogma? You really want that? Well, in the world we have today, paralleling with that quote, we have electromagnetic spectrum, which is expanding in the usage of it. Cyber, which is expanding in the usage. Unmanned aerial surface and undersea vehicles and directed energy. We're taking a laser gun on a ship to the Gulf. And I'm not sure where that next summer. And I'm not sure where we're going to go from there. Some people say missile defense. Others, we'll see. But something new is going to happen. And what I'm here to tell you folks is you need to be innovative because it's going to be too hard for doctrine to catch up with you. And you need to figure out, you'll need to figure out for us where we take this. And it'll be up to you. Innovation, you're going to need that. Now, Spruance, he was also bold. Some said, really? Well, I thought that was Halsey. Say, well, no, Halsey was loud. And he was boisterous. But Spruance was, you go out and you look at the picture out there, and you'll see he's got a piece of paper in his hand, perhaps the deploying order. And he's standing there, he's got the binoculars on, and you might say he's thinking about what to do next. And behind him are people kind of chewing one in his ear, saying we need to do this, that, this is what we need to do. And he's thinking it through. He's thinking, well, who's accountable for this whole thing? What are we going to do, and what's the risk versus the gain in this? And he thought about that in a very important time, during the Battle of Midway. He served at Midway very well, and it sort of defined him. He went on to command the 5th Fleet. By the way, I'm not going to match Christensen on quoting historical factoids. I just got a few more. He commanded the 5th Fleet and Sink Pack, and then he came back here. But it defined him during his action there at Midway, where after a victorious set of decisions, he said, hey, we're looking pretty good. Folks said, hey, we need to pursue the fleet. We hear there's some damaged carriers. We got to go west. And he's saying, I go too far west, I'm going to get out of position. Is that really value? And some said, yeah, you got to do it. But he said in the back of his mind, they think of that piece of paper he's got out there. What Nimitz told him, he said, don't risk the fleet. You got to think of the longer term. What's 3 moves down the road? We only got so many of these carriers and these ships, and you got to use them boldly, you got to use them with accountability, and you got to be judicious with them. And he put that through his head. He chose not to do that. He was calculated. Some said it's an unpopular decision to not chase east and try and chase down a damaged fleet. And by not doing it, though, he actually preserved the Pacific Fleet for the next fight and many more important ones after that. There were lessons learned in the back of his head, war games he learned here at the War College, and he's spoken about that in some of his memoirs. He avoided conflict when it was needed to be avoided and preserved the fleet to fight another day when it was even more important to what he did. So today we need people that are willing to do a similar matter. When you walk out of here, take a gander at that. You're going to be in a position somewhat similar. You're holding the piece of paper, got your binocs on, somebody wants to know what you want to do, and there'll be people buzzing in your ear saying you got to do this and do that. And only you can make that decision. How are you going to do it? How are you going to think it through? This place gives you a nice little sequence of how you might do that. Decide how you're going to put the knowledge in action and inspire your subordinates to do the same. Teach them how to make decisions, okay? It's a little bit of an art, but it's a big piece of science as well. So judiciousness. He was judicious, was Spruance, as part of his great leadership. He knew he had limited pilots. Everybody thinks aircraft. These are flown by pilots, hello? You know, you've got to have them, and that they were a hard commodity to come by in World War II. They're still hard to come by today, skilled pilots. He's got aircraft, he's got time, maybe a little bit, and fuel. Huge issue. How much fuel do we have? Where are we going to get our next drink of gas? And these carriers gobbled up fuel, not only the carrier themselves, but the airplanes. So how do I do that? And when do we make sure that we will have these carriers for the next really important item? He thought that through, did Spruance. After World War II, he became the president here, of course. I mentioned that before. A lot of changes in our Navy. 80% reduction in the number of ships just first year after the war. We just started retiring. We don't need them. We started decommissioning people and officers here and there. And there was, as you could probably imagine, a lot of competition for money. Where are we going to go next? Spruance said, okay, what do we need for the future? How do I divest? How do we divest ourselves of talent bases? And he started up here courses and a curriculum in divested thought of aviation. Sure, that's the right thing to do. We were just getting rolling in that. Of course, surface warfare, but atomic energy and electronics. Something new. I said, what the heck are we studying that for? He said, well, I think we might need it. Lo and behold, very, very bright guy looking out there to the future. He balanced the limited resources that the Navy would have for the future. So we're kind of in an inflection point. It's not like the end of World War II. Okay? It's not going to be exactly like that, but it's a change. We have a Budget Control Act. Okay, and either that will get adapted or in a different manner, or we will have sequestration, which is a defined entity. And how we go forward and how this nation rebalances to the Asia-Pacific and do it smartly using the right kind of resources is something we'll get started. But those of you in that kind of white band with all the other uniforms across the board will carry out from here. You learned a lot here, and it'll help you very much understand and take on that challenge. We need to manage your assets with deliberate and analytically in an analytical approach. What's that mean? It means you need to know where your people are, how you're using them, how you're using their time, what money you have or what funding that you control, and what assets do you have, be it in your squadron or wherever. I need to get a hold of that. Delegation of resource and resource management is something leaders can't do. And some say, I'm an operator, and say, those days are long gone. And if you think that that is all, you're a fool, and you will fail eventually in your leadership endeavor. So you need to understand what you got and how you're going to use it. So in the end, history is helpful. It's very helpful here. But it's not the only answer. It's not the answer. We've got to understand the past, and that will empower us very much to overcome future challenges and get it done right. And as leaders, we need to embrace innovation. The dynamics of this future that we're in and things that are taking place are so quick and they're so fast. Dogmatic business laid down in doctrine will not keep up with it. We'll try. Believe me, we'll try. But I'm telling you, it's going to be really tough. We need innovative people that are willing to seize that moment and understand the best way to use that. Be bold in thought. Be confident in your actions because you do know what you're doing. But you've got to be accountable also in your actions, and accountable, committed to the institution. So enjoy your accomplishment, and I want you to get to work, especially if we're white. We look forward to you, and we need you out there leading these sons and daughters, which is the greatest treasury that you parents here provide for us, as well as uncles and aunts. And I want to thank you parents here and the families supporting those people. You are the wind underneath their wings and enable them to fly and go off and do the great things for our nature. I ask God to bless all of you, our great Navy, our partners in the United States of America. Thank you for listening this morning. Congratulations.
Admiral Greenert, on behalf of the students, staff, and faculty, thank you for your comments, sir. Over this past academic year, we started a new tradition of giving the honor graduates a moment to address their fellow students. To represent all those we honored at yesterday's award ceremony and all of today's graduates, I'd like to invite Lieutenant Colonel Gingy Guilmartin, United States Army, winner of the Navy League Luce Award, to say a few words.
It seems as if the past 10 months have just flown by. Of course, we're now all used to moving at the speed of life, but today, however, we can take a small pause to reflect and say thanks. One issue this group doesn't need to reflect on is joint, interagency, and multinational operations. We're all invested, we all got that tattoo, and that one doesn't rub off. We've worked with Marines and the Coast Guard. We've worked for Australian generals and Afghan colonels. We've supervised Air Force captains, and we've learned that the Air Force FITREP actually encourages the use of emoticons and exclamation points. LOL, even smiley face. You know it's true, right? We've coordinated with the State Department, the FBI, intelligence professionals in remote locations, and we've also teased them about their cargo pants. We don't need to be sold on jointness, interagency, and multinational operations. In that one way, the Naval War College has been easy. In other ways, we've stretched our brains and our beliefs. This year has been a time to strengthen our knowledge, our sanctuary, and our networks. What do I mean by that? On knowledge, our first-rate faculty has helped us to discover that true knowledge isn't a right or wrong answer, but the process of asking the right questions. Knowledge is the ability to say, I don't know. Knowledge is the Einstein quote that says, if we knew what it was we were doing, it wouldn't be called research, would it? Knowledge is a lifelong process of never being satisfied and always being curious. So we send a deep thanks to the dedicated faculty and staff who have helped us gain new knowledge about geopolitics, strategy, and leadership. On sanctuary, our friends and our family provide us a safe place amidst the chaos. There are families who wait patiently in Brazil, Lithuania, India, Yemen, while their loved ones are far away. There are Newport neighbors who assist with cleanup after Sandy and snow shoveling after Nemo. They're resilient children who move too much and they wait for redeployment, but they still give mom or dad that quiet space to finish a paper. They are wives, husbands, partners, moms, and dads who provide all manner of support to this crazy lifestyle, and we owe a huge debt to them all. Finally, on networks, Naval War College students have used this past year to expand our networks. But the true value of these networks will not be realized today. It will be realized in the next 10 years. In 2015, a Navy captain will email a new admiral in Ghana and will call a new admiral in Japan. In 2017, an Army officer and his US AID sister will work together on a development strategy. In 2023, a Naval War College alum will lead a task force conducting exercises with El Salvadoran and Indonesian special forces. In this spirit, then, we shouldn't say goodbye, but instead we say Godspeed, fair winds and following seas, blue skies, and peace be with you until we see each other again. There are two final farewells from the student body, and this is a little bit of a surprise, but we want to say goodbye to Captain Ray Calladay and also to Admiral Christensen, who will be departing this summer. I was asked to pass on small mementos from the student body. For Captain Calladay, Adrian Galanek has spearheaded a fantastic photo book, and the inscription is, to the son of a Naval World War II veteran who was named after Admiral Ray Spruance. And sir, you've dedicated your life to the Navy, and you've definitely taken care of the whole student body and taken care of us. So on behalf of the entire student population, sir, here's your photo book, and thank you for everything. Best of luck. And for Admiral Christensen, sir, we know you love books, so we have two for you. The first one is to get you ready for Europe. It's a British history you can read on the plane, and it's titled Return of a King, The Battle for Afghanistan, 1839 to 1842 by William Dalrymple. The book says, quote, a retelling of the West's greatest imperial disaster in the East. S&P loves that kind of stuff, so. The second book serves for your new office. We know you keep an atlas that you mark with names of all your troops and your teammates and shipmates. But as you go global with your colleagues, we hope this pocket atlas can start you building those new bonds until you get your full-size library. So thank you very much, sir.
we're going to end that tradition. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll now confer diplomas and degrees to the graduates. Admiral Christensen, will you please approach your podium? Captain Perry Yaw, Director of Naval Command College, will present the diploma candidates.
With the Naval Command College Class of 2013, the Naval Staff College of 2013, the Naval Staff College Class 82, and diploma candidates of the College of Distance Education Class of 2013, please rise. Admiral Christensen, I have the honor to present candidates for the United States Naval War College diploma. They have been thoroughly examined and approved by the faculty.
I confer upon you the United States Naval War College diploma with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto.
Naval Command College, Naval Staff Colleges, diploma candidates of the College of Distance Education, please be seated.
College of Naval Warfare, College of Naval Command and Staff, and Master's Degrees candidates of the College of Distance Education, Class of 2013, please rise. Admiral Christensen, I have the honor to present the June 2013 candidates for the Master of Arts in National Security and Strategic Studies. They have been thoroughly examined and approved by the faculty.
By the power vested in me by the Secretary of the Navy in the accreditation of the New England Association of Schools and Colleges, I confer upon you the degree of Master of Arts in National Security and Strategic Studies.
College of Naval Warfare, College of Naval Command and Staff, and Master's Degree candidates of the College of Distance Education, please be seated.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join me once again in saluting with our applause the graduates of the United States Naval War College, Class of 2013, their families and guests.
The graduates will now receive their diplomas. Beyond the requirements for graduation, certain individuals have distinguished themselves through academic excellence. A diploma with highest distinction is presented to the top 5% of each graduating class. A diploma with distinction is presented to the next 15% of each graduating class. Graduates will proceed to the stage as their name is read. Guests, please hold your applause until all names have been read so that all names and recognitions may be heard. The order of graduation will be as follows: the Naval Command College, College of Naval Warfare, the College of Distance Education, the two Naval Staff Colleges, and then finally the College of Naval Command and Staff.
Admiral, if you can get in position. Perry, you're up.
Graduating from the Naval Command College, Commander Adnan Agasha, Albanian Naval Forces. Lieutenant Colonel Fudil Tabti, Algerian Naval Forces. Commander Marcelo Tarapau, Argentine Navy. Captain Chris Smith, Royal Australian Navy. Captain Nazmul Hassan, Bangladesh Navy. Captain Sergio Miranda, Brazilian Navy. Captain Kirill Mihailov, Bulgarian Navy. Captain Robert Ferguson, Royal Canadian Navy. Commander Juan Helmke, Chilean Navy. Commander Alberto Godoy, Colombian Navy.
Smile.
Captain Raid Mohammed, Egyptian Navy. Captain Rene Marino Monroy, El Salvador Navy. Commander Thibault Dupazes, French Navy. Captain Ramaz Papidze, Coast Guard of Georgia. Commander Andreas Muga, German Navy. Captain Kofi Faidu, Ghana Navy. Commander Gerissimos Pavlotos, Hellenic Navy. Captain Sushil Menon, Indian Navy. Colonel Mohammed Faisal, Indonesian Navy. Commander Ziv Ram, Israel Navy. Captain Masafumi Nishiwaki, Japan Maritime Self-Defense Force. Captain Mohammed Al Narat, Royal Jordanian Naval Force. Commander Jaejun Lee, Republic of Korea Navy. Commander Yoo Tae Song, Republic of Korea Navy. Commander Naif Alaskar, Kuwait Naval Force. Colonel Hosni Daher, Lebanese Navy.
Smile.
Captain Abdul Hafid El Aribe, Libyan Navy. Commander Arturas Kaznauskas, Lithuanian Naval Forces. Commander Yusman Ostadi, Royal Malaysian Navy.
Smile.
Lieutenant Colonel Moulay Morchidi, Royal Moroccan Air Force. Commander Itzhard Vanazinga, Royal Netherlands Navy. Captain Yaminu Musa, Nigerian Navy. Commander Øyvind Bergstrøm, Royal Norwegian Navy.
Smile.
Captain Imran Iftihar, Pakistan Navy. Commander Philip Palawara, Papua New Guinea Defense Force. Captain Alfonso Torres Jr., Philippine Navy.
Smile, brother.
Captain Marian Savulescu, Romanian Naval Forces. Captain Naif Alshamari, Royal Saudi Navy Forces. Commander Sikumbuzo Misikinya, South African Navy. Captain Damika Sanjiva Diaz, Sri Lankan Navy. Commander Jens Nykvist, Royal Swedish Navy. Captain Shuzwe Lu, Taiwan Navy. Commander Hasachai Mankang, Royal Thai Navy. Captain Andriy Ryzhenko, Ukrainian Naval Forces. Commander Roger Redwin, Royal Navy.
Oh, you're going out of order.
Graduating with distinction, Lieutenant Colonel Ian Clark, United States Marine Corps. Commander Scott Ergel, United States Navy. And Staff Colonel Mohammed Abdul Hafid, Yemen Naval Forces and Coastal Defense.
Graduating from the College of Naval Warfare, Lieutenant Colonel David Michael Benson, United States Air Force. Lieutenant Colonel Andrew J. Bergen, United States Marine Corps. Lieutenant Colonel Gregory Allen Blackwell, New Hampshire Army National Guard. Lieutenant Colonel Chad A. Blair, United States Marine Corps. Commander Michael J. Brand, United States Navy. Graduating with distinction, Lieutenant Colonel Bradley Bridges, United States Air Force. Ms. Kimberly D. Brown, Maritime Administration. Lieutenant Colonel Gregory P. Butler, United States Air Force Reserve. Graduating with distinction, Dr. Douglas Amend Chamberlain, Central Intelligence Agency. Colonel John J. Kitka, United States Army. Graduating with distinction, Lieutenant Colonel Kevin F. Sioka, United States Army. Graduating with highest distinction, Lieutenant Colonel Christopher L. Connolly, United States Army. Commander Tremaine Gerard Kreiner, United States Navy. Ms. Lori Peterson Dando, Department of State. Ms. Darby S. Dillon, Defense Senior Leadership Development Program. Mr. Joseph M. Domino, Federal Bureau of Investigation. Commander Brad P. Donnelly, United States Navy. Ms. Bronwyn Douglas, United States Coast Guard. Graduating with distinction, Mr. Eric K. Keokoa Fisher. Lieutenant Colonel Joseph E. Francor, Air National Guard. Mr. Eugene T. Fury, Department of State. Graduating with distinction, Lieutenant Colonel Stuart D. Ferner, United States Army. Captain Claudia And Christiane Geltzer, United States Coast Guard. Commander Stephen C. Goff, United States Navy. Mr. Jorge E. Gracia, Department of Defense. Graduate with distinction, Lieutenant Colonel Eugenia Gingy Guilmartin, U.S. Army. Lieutenant Colonel Brian S. Halloran, United States Army. Mr. C. E. Higginbotham, Federal Bureau of Investigation. Graduate with distinction, Lieutenant Colonel Michael P. Hosey, United States Army. Commander Michelle C. Huddleston, United States Navy. Ms. Colleen E. Hyland, Department of State. Graduating with distinction, Lieutenant Colonel Douglas D. Jones, United States Army. Commander Timothy F. Keaton, United States Navy. Captain Brett J. Corade, United States Navy. Lieutenant Colonel Thomas G. LaCroix, United States Marine Corps. Graduating with distinction, Lieutenant Colonel George E. Lewis III, United States Army. Graduating with highest distinction, Lieutenant Colonel Joel J. Luker, United States Air Force. Ms. Heidi M. Mlarchik, Defense Senior Leadership Development Program. Graduating with highest distinction, Mr. Rick Marsh, Defense Senior Leadership Development Program. Ms. Geneva R. Maxson, Defense Senior Leadership Development Program. Graduating with highest distinction, Colonel Brian Robert McCullough, United States Army. Captain Buck McDermott, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander Lee McIlvain, United States Navy. Lieutenant Colonel John V. Meyer III, United States Army. Lieutenant Colonel Ricardo Miagani, United States Marine Corps. Graduating with distinction, Mr. Marcus R.J. McKelly, Department of State. Commander Scott M. Miller, United States Navy. Colonel Kevin W. Milton, United States Army. Colonel Arthur Moore III, United States Air Force. Graduating with distinction, Lieutenant Colonel Kenneth E. Moss, United States Air Force. Colonel Diane D. Panis, United States Army. Colonel Perry V. Panos, United States Air Force Reserve. Graduating with distinction, Colonel Jeffrey D. Peterson, United States Army. Lieutenant Commander John P. Perkins, United States Navy. Lieutenant Colonel James D. Petrick, United States Air Force. Mr. Peter G. Pines, Department of State. Graduating with distinction, Captain Joe Piontek, United States Navy. Lieutenant Colonel Regina Powell, United States Army Reserve. Commander David S. Raymer, United States Navy. Commander Cynthia A. Ramsey, United States Navy. Ms. Beverly Dawn Rivera, National Security Agency. Lieutenant Colonel Brian T. Runkle, United States Air Force. Lieutenant Colonel Gerard F. Ryan, Jr., U.S. Air Force. Graduating with distinction, Lieutenant Colonel Thomas B. Savage, United States Marine Corps. Ms. Lori A. Schraw, Office of the Director of National Intelligence. Commander Mark J. Shepard, United States Coast Guard. Lieutenant Colonel Ryan Sherwood, United States Air Force. Colonel Justin B. Smith, United States Air Force. Mr. Matthew David Smith, Department of State. Special Agent Andrew P. Snowden, Naval Criminal Investigative Service. Commander William R. Timmons, United States Coast, excuse me, Captain William R. Timmons, United States Coast Guard. Ms. Chris Trugott, Defense Senior Leadership Defense Program. Mr. Hale C. Van Kennett, Department of State. Lieutenant Colonel William Michael Wando, United States Marine Corps. Colonel Andrew J. Weatherston, United States Army. Graduating with highest distinction, Lieutenant Colonel Scott E. Williams, United States Air Force. Graduating with distinction, Lieutenant Colonel J. D. Wiley, United States Marine Corps. Graduating with distinction, Commander Timothy H. Young, United States Navy. Lieutenant Colonel Zachary B. Ziner, United States Air Force.
Graduating from the College of Distance Education, with highest distinction, Mr. David M. Adams, Government Accountability Office. Graduating with highest distinction, Mr. Robert G. Adams III, Naval Mine and Anti-Submarine Warfare Command. Lieutenant Commander Nicholas J. Borman, U.S. Navy. Mr. Michael G. Brown, Defense Intelligence Agency. Graduating with distinction, Lieutenant Robert L. Byrd II, United States Coast Guard. Graduating with distinction, Lieutenant Colonel George Cadwaddler, Jr., United States Marine Corps. Lieutenant Commander Scott E. Carlson, Chaplain Corps, United States Navy Reserve. Colonel Angelo J. Carmelo, Jr., United States Army Reserve. Mr. Michael A. Clauser, United States House of Representatives and a proud member of the United States Navy Reserve, Lieutenant J.G. Michael A. Clauser, United States Africa Command. Captain W. Michael Crane, United States Navy Reserve. Lieutenant Colonel Eloy L. E. Cuevas, United States Army. Graduating with distinction, Lieutenant Commander William E. Davis, United States Navy Reserve. Mr. Robert J. Dean, Department of Commerce. Ms. Elizabeth N. Decker, United States House of Representatives. Graduating with highest distinction, Mr. Brian C. Diffel, United States Senate. Mr. Eric P. Dolatowski, Department of Defense. Commander Thomas N. Dwan, Justice Advocate General Corps, United States Navy Reserve. Lieutenant Carlton T. Brown, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander Darnell S. Edwards, United States Navy. Mr. Allen S. Elias, United States Senate, graduating with distinction. Mr. Ryan M. Evans, U.S. House of Representatives. Graduating with distinction, Ms. Lisa A. Feldhausen, Office of Naval Intelligence. Commander John L. Philostrat II, United States Navy Reserve. Mr. Roger A. Fowler, Jr., Federal Bureau of Investigation. Lieutenant Commander John P. Franco, United States Navy Reserve. Lieutenant Commander Nathaniel D. Gordon, United States Navy. Lieutenant Jordan M. Gottfried, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander Jason M. Haynes, United States Navy Reserve. Mr. Richard C. Hirsch III, Department of Homeland Security. Rachel Hines, U.S. House of Representatives. Lieutenant Commander Rodolfo Jacobo, United States Navy. Captain Michael J. Yeager, Justice Advocate General Corps, United States Navy. Mr. Aaron C. Jones, U.S. House of Representatives. Lieutenant Magdalena Keel, United States Navy. Graduating with distinction, Lieutenant Colonel Hunter R. Kellogg, United States Marine Corps. Lieutenant Sandeep Kumar, United States Navy. Mr. Michael C. Kerlin, United States House of Representatives. Lieutenant Brian D. Larder, United States Navy Reserve. Mr. Patrick M. Large, United States House of Representatives. Dr. Richard Laws. Lieutenant Commander John R. Logan, Chaplain Corps, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander Jonathan J. Lynn, United States Naval Reserve. Lieutenant V. Jesse P. McCassett, United States Navy. Mr. Christopher J. Madar, Government Accountability Office, graduating with distinction. Ms. Elizabeth M. McWhorter, United States House of Representatives. Captain Daniel J. Myers, United States Marine Corps. Graduating with highest distinction, Lieutenant Commander Nicholas Miller, United States Navy. Graduating with distinction, Lieutenant Stephen T. Morgan, United States Navy Reserve. Ms. Elizabeth D. Morris, Government Accountability Office. Mr. Stephen A. Mort, United States Coast Guard Headquarters. Graduating with highest distinction, Lieutenant Julie K. Moss, Supply Corps, United States Navy Reserve. Commander Glenn E. Murray, United States Navy. Major David S. Naska, United States Marine Corps, graduating with distinction. Lieutenant Commander James M. O'Mara IV, United States Coast Guard. Commander Kevin C. L. Owens, United States Navy Reserve. Ms. Catherine E. Parker, United States Senate. Ms. Kathleen A. Taylor, United States Senate. Mr. Daniel M. Burgess, United States House of Representatives. Graduating with distinction, Lieutenant Commander Peter P. Pascucci, United States Navy. Graduating with highest distinction, Lieutenant Commander Catherine N. Passietta, Justice Advocate General's Corps, United States Navy. Graduating with distinction, Mr. Claude M. Petticord, Department of Defense. Mr. Brian J. Perez, United States Department of Justice. Lieutenant Commander Margaret M. Reed, United States Navy. Lieutenant Renee J. Rankin, United States Navy. Commander Valerie J. Regi, Medical Service Corps, United States Navy. Mrs. Veronica S. Sebastian, Naval War College, Newport, Rhode Island. Lieutenant Commander Robert P. Senko, Medical Service Corps, United States Navy. Lieutenant Antonia K. Shea, U.S. Navy. Captain Brian W. Shields, Dental Corps, United States Naval Reserve. Ms. Erica A. Strebel, United States House of Representatives. Mrs. Paula D. Thomas, Pacific Command. Ms. Teddy G. Thurgood, Department of Homeland Security. Ms. Serena V. Vandegrift, Federal Bureau of Investigation. Graduating with distinction, Mr. Jason V. Vasilikos, Government Accountability Office. Mrs. K. L. Ventiger-Schulman, Department of the Navy. Mrs. Mindy A. Walker, United States House of Representatives. Mrs. Katrina E. Worrell, Department of Defense. Mr. Gregory S. Zahn, Federal Government, Washington, D.C. Lieutenant Commander Elizabeth L. Alley, United States Navy Reserve. Captain Jonathan D. Blacker, United States Navy Reserve. Graduating with highest distinction, Mr. Christopher J. Bognano, United States House of Representatives. Captain George M. Cox, United States Navy Reserve. Lieutenant Commander Deborah K. Davis Reed, Supply Corps, United States Navy. Colonel Dwayne C. DeVance, United States Army Reserve. Commander Paula D. Dunn, United States Navy Reserve. Mr. Andrew W. Gernt, United States Senate. Graduating with distinction, Captain Christopher D. Glass, Sr., United States Navy Reserve. Graduating with highest distinction, Captain Dean A. Gould, United States Navy. Graduating with distinction, Lieutenant Eric E. Grawunder, United States Navy. Lieutenant Matthew A. Harris, United States Navy. Mr. John P. Hill III, National Security Agency, Washington, D.C. Commander Michelle D. Jackson, United States Navy Reserve and the United States Naval War College. Commander Mark W. Kleinhentz, Supply Corps, United States Navy Reserve. Captain Victoria Mazzarella, United States Navy Reserve. Mr. Tobin J. McMurdy, Government Accountability Office. Lieutenant Wendy E. Meyer, United States Coast Guard Reserve. Commander Kerry D. Moore, United States Navy Reserve. Lieutenant Jason Y. Osuga, United States Navy. Graduating with highest distinction, Mr. Sherman Patrick III, United States Senate. Lieutenant Commander John F. Penders IV, United States Navy Reserve. Lieutenant Commander David A. Rukowski, United States Navy Reserve. Lieutenant Robert S. Stewart, United States Navy. Mr. Jason R. Suslovich, United States House of Representatives.
Graduating from the Naval Staff College, Capitan Brahim Diaf, Naval Forces, Algeria. Lieutenant Commander Azad Sadikov, Azerbaijan Naval Forces. Lieutenant Commander Mohammed Kibria, Bangladesh Navy. Lieutenant Theodore Kabakov, Bulgarian Navy. Lieutenant Trifon Mitishev, Bulgarian Navy. Lieutenant Commander Gordon Roy, Royal Canadian Navy. Lieutenant Commander Herman Castro, Colombian Navy. Lieutenant Commander Ahmed Al-Saraf, Egyptian Navy. Lieutenant Commander Francisco Mejia, El Salvador Navy. Lieutenant Commander Arto Reinma, Estonian Navy. Lieutenant Commander Dhanajay Singh, Indian Navy. Major Dwi Sugianto, Indonesian Navy. Lieutenant Commander Athir Al-Shawi, Iraqi Navy. Lieutenant Commander Eli Ginsberg, Israel Navy. Lieutenant Commander Yoshiro Inagawa, Japan Maritime Self-Defense Force. Lieutenant Colonel Bashir Malkawi, Royal Jordanian Air Force. Lieutenant Colonel Tawfiq Al-Sardi, Royal Jordanian Navy. Lieutenant Quanish Duanov, Kazakhstan Navy. Lieutenant Commander Seungwon Jun, Republic of Korea Navy. Lieutenant Commander Young Ho Kong, Republic of Korea Navy. Lieutenant Colonel Hussein Alojmi, Kuwait Naval Forces. Lieutenant Colonel Amin Al Khalifa, Kuwait Navy. Sorry, Amin. Lieutenant Commander Miguel Lopez, Mexican Navy. Lieutenant Commander Kareem Amin, Royal Moroccan Navy. Commander Tomas Anderson, Royal Norwegian Navy. Lieutenant Commander Abdallah Al-Rashdi, Royal Navy of Oman. Lieutenant Commander Jawad Hussein, Pakistan Navy. Major Mohammed Al-Kuwari, Qatar Emiri Naval Forces. Lieutenant Codrin Misaresh, Romanian Naval Forces. Lieutenant Commander Keder Al-Shari, Royal Saudi Naval Forces. Lieutenant Abdul C, Senglagese Navy. Major Ayang Kokfai, Republic of Singapore Navy. Lieutenant Commander Yagama Indica Da Silva, Sri Lanka Navy. Lieutenant Commander She Kung Ping, Taiwan Navy. Lieutenant Commander Munir Onaiz, Tunisian Navy. Lieutenant Commander Murat Baykal, Turkish Naval Forces. Lieutenant Commander Igor Gorin, Naval Forces, Ukraine. Lieutenant Commander Neil Garbett, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander Milo Kasiak, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander John Stump, United States Navy. Lieutenant Colonel Humaid Al-Ramithi, United Arab Emirates Navy. Lieutenant Mohammed Al-Fasa, Yemen Coast Guard. Lieutenant Commander Waleed Al-Said, Yemi Naval Forces and Coastal Defense. Lieutenant Ma'atala Mohammed Lakhdar, Algerian Naval Forces. Lieutenant Alfredo De Assis, Angolan Navy. Lieutenant Commander Lopez Augusto, Angolan Marine Corps. Lieutenant Jafar Sayedov, Azerbaijan Republic's Navy. Senior Lieutenant Carlin Bethel, Royal Bahamas Defense Force. Lieutenant Commander Raymond King, Royal Bahaman Defense Force. Lieutenant Commander Ashraf Riyad, Bangladesh Navy. Commander Rodrigo Pace, Brazilian Navy. Lieutenant Commander Lubomir Balkansky, Bulgarian Navy. Lieutenant Commander Ivan Yordanov, Bulgarian Navy. Lieutenant Bernard Kak, Cameroon Navy. Lieutenant Marinko Rubic, Croatian Navy. Lieutenant Commander McDonnell Belliard, Dominican Navy. Lieutenant David Velez, Ecuadorian Navy. Lieutenant Commander Christian Zienebald, German Navy. Lieutenant Commander Manuel Alvarez, Guatemalan Navy. Commandant Junior Grade Mohammed Syed, Indian Coast Guard. Lieutenant Commander Binsar Sitoris, Indonesian Navy. Lieutenant Commander Dmitry Yankovs, Latvian Naval Forces. Lieutenant Commander Ahmed Bashara, Lebanese Navy. Lieutenant Colonel Jamil Lahoud, Lebanese Armed Forces. Lieutenant Commander Maurice Us Shakinis, Lithuanian Naval Forces. Lieutenant Commander Harfaisal Hamid, Royal Malaysian Navy. Lieutenant Commander Mohammed Hamza, Mauritian Navy. Lieutenant Commander Jelko Idanich, Montenegro Navy. Commander Mizaro Muzui, Mozambique Navy. Lieutenant Commander Abdallah Al Jabri, Royal Navy of Oman. Lieutenant Commander Adnan Al-Kiyumi, Royal Navy of Oman. Lieutenant Commander Mohammed Amjad, Pakistan Navy. Lieutenant Commander Luis Castaneda, Peruvian Navy. Lieutenant Commander Lamar De La Calzada, Philippine Navy. Inspector Taivete Tunsani, Ministry of Police and Prison, Samoa. Major Augustine Lim, Republic of Singapore Navy. Lieutenant Carl Abrams, South African Navy. Commander Chu Ya-Ching, Taiwan Navy. Major Jones Mwangiga, Tanzania Navy. Lieutenant Commander Wayne Amor, Trinidad and Tobago Coast Guard. Lieutenant Commander Mehdi Hassouna, Tunisian Navy. Lieutenant Commander Mustafa Kumek, Turkish Naval Forces. Commander Jorge Urrutia Schneider, Uruguayan Navy. Lieutenant Commander Vuong Dinh Man, the Vietnam People's Navy.
Graduating from the College of Naval Command and Staff, Lieutenant Commander Melissa Angarita, United States Navy. Major Sarah S. Babbitt, United States Air Force. Major John M. Balbuena, United States Army. Major Joseph C. Bell, United States Army. Lieutenant Commander John G. Boger, United States Navy. Graduating with distinction, Major Michael L. Boswell, United States Air Force. Major William P. Brown, Jr., United States Marine Corps. Lieutenant Henry L. Bush, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander Jonathan Austin Carter, United States Coast Guard. Major David Christopher Castillo, United States Army. Ms. Diana L. Chansey, Special Operations Command. Mr. Christopher James Clarkin, Department of State. Major Thomas J. Cleaver, United States Marine Corps. Major Rosanna M. Clemente, United States Army. Major Tamisha P. Coatney, United States Air Force. Major David S. Collins, United States Army. Lieutenant Commander Robert Carlton Comfer, United States Coast Guard. Graduating with distinction, Major Sean S. Conlon, Jr., United States Army. Graduating with distinction, Lieutenant Matthew E. Davin, United States Navy. Graduating with distinction, Major Patrick T. Dierig, United States Air Force. Commander Select, Ryan Pickle Dill, United States Navy. Major Casey D. Elam, United States Marine Corps. Major Alexander B. Fafinski, United States Air Force. Graduating with the highest distinction, Mr. Christian E. Fieri, Special Operations Command. Ms. Misun P. Fetzer, Department of State. Major Larry Fenner, United States Air Force. Lieutenant Commander Matthew S. Fine, United States Coast Guard. Special Agent Gregory D. Ford, Naval Criminal Investigative Service. Major Scott A. Francis, United States Army. Ms. Adrienne Marie Galanik, Department of State. Major Jason C. Gallardo, United States Army. Major Michael R. Gary, United States Army. Graduating with distinction, Major Sean H. Gibb, United States Army. Lieutenant Commander Peter Hogel, Jr., United States Navy. Major Terrence J. Holmes, United States Air Force. Major Jake Hosfeld, United States Marine Corps. Graduating distinction, Major David C. A. Hyman, United States Marine Corps. Major John Patrick Kearns, Jr., United States Marine Corps. Graduating with highest distinction, Lieutenant Commander Shane Lansford, United States Navy. Major Jamie R. Lavallee, United States Army. Lieutenant Commander Matthew Loverink, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander Thomas R. Lovett, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander Michael Jason James McCumber, United States Navy. Mr. Victor Modesto Marks Martino, Military Sealift Command. Graduating with distinction, Lieutenant Commander Patrick C. Marsloff, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander Zachary B. McCarty, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander Scott Edwin McKellar, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander James F. McKenna, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander Brandy McNabb, United States Navy. Major Jennifer A. Nash, United States Navy. Oh, excuse me, Marine Corps. Apologies. All right, I'm sorry. It's always one. Lieutenant Commander David Scott Nava, United States Navy. Major Jeremy O'Hearn, United States Army. Lieutenant Commander Scott Sherm Oliver, United States Navy. Major Kirk Michael Olson, United States Air Force. Mr. Kevin E. Orfall. Major Timothy R. Palmer, United States Army. Lieutenant Colonel James R. Peckham, Jr., United States Army. Commander Justin D. Peters, United States Coast Guard. Mr. Kent D. Piesbergen. Lieutenant Commander Jeff Richer, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander Kyle Patrick Riley, United States Navy. Major Reyes J. Rivas, United States Marine Corps. Major Jeffrey J. Roche, United States Air Force. Graduating with distinction, Field Operations Supervisor John Lewis Rodrigue, United States Border Patrol. Graduating with distinction, Lieutenant Commander Gary A. Riles, United States Navy. Mr. Keith R. Schwacker, National Geospatial Intelligence Agency. Lieutenant Commander Major E. Sellers, United States Navy. Graduating with highest distinction, Major Matthew J. Skaggs, United States Army. Graduating with distinction, Mr. Robert DeBoe Smith. Graduating with distinction, Major Joseph M. Stengel, United States Air Force. Graduating with distinction, Mr. Edgar P. Tam, Defense Intelligence Agency. Major Aaron Craig Teller, United States Army. Major Daniel W. Thompson, United States Marine Corps. Lieutenant Commander Robert M. Thompson, United States Navy. Lieutenant Commander Jason L. Tomlinson, United States Navy. Graduated with highest distinction, Lieutenant Commander Adam J. Walker, United States Navy. Graduating with highest distinction, Lieutenant Commander Joshua F. Wenker, United States Navy. Graduated with highest distinction, Major Eric W. Widmar, United States Army. Lieutenant Commander Ty C. Weiss, United States Navy. And finally, Lieutenant Commander Matthew D. Willer, United States Navy. Well, actually, will all graduates please rise and all guests be seated? Admiral Christensen, if you'll please move to your podium for the charge.
Zeno, thank you for being here, for your participation in this ceremony, for your inspirational remarks, and for your relentless loyalty to your sailors and your Navy. And today, especially, for your loyalty to this college. To our faculty and staff, thank you for a great day and for bringing us to this day. To the families and friends of today's graduates, once again, I thank you for joining us. Your presence has made this ceremony even more memorable for your graduates. A final word to our graduates. You have demonstrated admirable discipline by your hard work and by making the most of the enormous investment that your country made in you. You depart with greater trust and confidence in your fellow services and in your international partners. On behalf of the Naval War College, faculty, staff, and students you leave behind, I wish you and your family success and happiness in the years ahead. God bless you all.
Graduates, please be seated. Navy Band Northeast, post. Ladies and gentlemen, shortly we will now sing together the service songs of our nation's armed forces. The words for each song will be broadcast on the screen here above the stage. We ask that each military and civilian service member, veteran, and family member please stand as their service song is sung, and then please remain standing until the completion of all service songs. Will all Coast Guard veterans, staff, faculty, students, and their families please rise? And sing. Stay standing, please. Stay standing. Will all Marine Corps veterans, staff, faculty, students, and their families please rise? Okay, we heard that. All right, let's hear some singing from the Air Force. Will Air Force veterans, staff, faculty, students, or their families please rise? Goldie? Army veterans, staff, faculty, students, and their families, please rise. Thank you. You guys are going to have to bring those things back up here. You're not graduating now. I'm sorry. Thought that I'd beat that out of you. All right. Well, all Navy veterans, staff, faculty, students, and their families, please rise. Beat Army. Chaplain Rosander will now deliver the benediction. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise or remain standing for the benediction.
Let us pray. Eternal Father, for these men and women, a rigorous and challenging academic year is now at a close, but their voyage continues. As they go from here, serving on land, sea, or air, at home and abroad, may their knowledge, skills, wisdom, and friendships be fully utilized in maintaining peace and security around the world. Please enable them with honor, courage, and commitment in all things, and protect them as they serve, granting them safety and success. Lord, we also ask you to watch over those who serve today in harm's way. Please be near to their families and those who still recover from the effects of war. Now bless these men and women as they go forth to do great things. Thank you for the service they render to their nations. Please be with them and their families and friends as they depart for new destinations and challenges. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing for the departure of the official party and dignitaries. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes today's ceremony. Thank you all for coming today, and safe travels to everyone home.